So what are some of the challenges that you guys have had to consider, and then what have you guys seen as a result coming from that?
None. It's actually been smooth sailing. No challenges.
Don't get into this journey with someone you don't like talking to every night. That's what I would say. I mean, this stuff's really hard. This is probably the hardest side of my job because it's so dynamic. The pace of how this evolves is just incredible. And there's 1,000 points of failure. And you can't do it alone. And so working through expecting not everything to go how you thought it was going to be on paper and picking partners that you're comfortable getting into the tough stuff with is really important. Mike and I fight all the time. I feel like we're actually really toned down today. But we've got a really strong relationship that allow us to do that and still enjoy each other. As well, I think that extends to your partner relationships. You can't get married to a partner that you don't enjoy being in a lot of meetings with.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree. I mean, at the end of the day, there are things that we needed to do to protect Brunswick's interest in moving this forward. And we had to take a bit of a leap of faith, but not just trust that we would get the outcomes we needed. And so we've had to make decisions, right? We've actually been a net kind of consumer of Avionos capability, and they've been a great partner. Right, we are not a cloud native, digital native company that has emerged in the last 20 years. We are a company that's 175 years old that's trying to make a transformation and recognizing a trend to digital engagement. And so we just don't have the inherent expertise. We're building it, and we're finding and navigating and building the right partnerships where I think we're going to be in a really good place, but it hasn't been without its issues with certain vendors, with certain partners. It hasn't been without its challenges across our divisions and making sure that we can get everybody aligned on why we need to move in a certain direction relative to operating model, relative to competency we need to build in-house. That has come easier with credibility. Lauren and I just went through a pretty significant proposal to our leadership team that took some time, and we had to talk to a lot of people, but I feel like I have less scarring from the first conversation we had 2 years ago to where we are today. So that's really what credibility brings. And I don't think Mike Adams alone or Lauren alone in selling that next step in a journey would have been successful. I think if you take anything away from this webinar, you really need a business IT partnership that makes up what I view as a digital business partnership to bring the level of credibility that you need to get all the stakeholders, the senior stakeholders on board.